There are several muscles that make up the mid-upper back. The traps, rhomboids, teres major and minor, erector spinae, and infraspinatus. Most of these are responsible for one primary movement, retraction of the scapula. Anytime you pull a weight toward your body horizontally from out in front of you, such as when you row, all those muscles are firing. When it comes to building a thick, well-developed back, you must row to grow, which is why the barbell row is by far the best overall mass builder when it comes to back development. Not only are you building back thickness through loading the function of scapula retraction, but the lats, which are responsible for back width, are getting a good deal of stimulus as well. Not to mention, anytime we're pulling a weight toward our body, be it vertically or horizontally, we're engaging our biceps to a significant degree. Want bigger arms? Pull heavier weight. The main issue I find with this exercise is that most people tend to use more weight than they can handle. Jerking back and forth and using a ton of body English to get the weight up is a telltale sign that the load is too heavy. If you're moving anything other than your arms, chances are that you're not going to maximize the amount of load you're putting on the target muscle. If you let momentum move the weight, you're just decreasing muscle fiber recruitment while increasing your risk of injury. Remember, this is an upper body pull, not a full body jerk. Controlling the weight throughout the entire range, even if it means a little less weight on the bar, is not only going to reduce the risk of a potentially serious injury, it'll also increase the amount of tension you're putting on the target muscle. Another common mistake most people make when performing this exercise is standing too upright. Although this may allow for heavier loads, it's reducing the range of motion we're able to move the weight through, rendering the exercise useless. Now, before we jump into the proper technique for this exercise, let me just point out that there are a number of variations for this movement. It can be performed from the ground using a dead stop where you're resetting after each repetition. This is known as the Penlay row. It can be done with a narrower grip where you're gripping the bar just outside the width of your knees and rowing towards your midsection. This will force your arms to stay close to your body, making for better lat activation. And it can also be performed using an underhand grip where you're gripping the bar at just about shoulder width, which will allow you to keep your elbows even closer to your body, allowing you to further emphasize the lats. For this video, however, we're going to focus on the standard variation of the exercise as it is, in my opinion, the best variation for overall back mass. How to barbell row. The setup for the barbell row is quite simple. The movement could start either from the ground or from a power rack at about hip height. If you're using a rack, you can skip the first couple of steps and start from the point where we're standing upright. If you're starting from the floor, walk up to the bar and stand with your midfoot underneath it, feet shoulder width apart. If your shins are touching the bar, you're too close. Grab the bar with an overhand grip, arms slightly wider than shoulder width, and deadlift the bar into a standing position. From here, you'll push your hips back while slightly bending the knees and lowering the bar, and stop once you've reached a 15 to 30 degree angle. This is something you'll have to play with a bit before finding the position that feels most comfortable for you. The more parallel to the ground you can get, the better. Now you're ready to pull. Brace your core by breathing in and tightening your abs. Pull the weight toward your lower chest. Squeeze your back at the top, but don't hold the weight up there. Control the weight back down until your arms are fully extended before initiating the next rep. This will ensure that you're pulling the weight through a full range of motion. To summarize, grip the bar overhand with arms slightly outside shoulder width and deadlift the bar into a standing position. Lower the bar by pushing your hips back while bending the knees slightly. Then pull, don't jerk, the bar toward your lower chest. Squeeze your back at the top and control the weight on the way down. Once your arms are completely straight, initiate the following repetition. Did you find this video helpful? If so, click the like button below as it'll truly help out the channel. Is there a different exercise you want to master? Let me know what it is in the comment section below and I'll try to make a video on it. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications so you never miss another video. I hope this was helpful, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.